John, we are in the semi-finals from this World Championship here in Prague. So far, what is your summary from this event?
Well, this has been an extremely spectacular event. A lot of spectator records has been broken. We have also had an enormous amount of good publicity in Czech Republic and outside. We are very close to reach 150 broadcasted TV games, and most of all, the event has shown what enormous potential also the Floorball World Championships has as a sporting event.
Talking about live games or TV station games, how can we imagine this? Is that like you going from TV station to TV station, or are they approaching IFF?
Well, it started by going to one TV station and then making a deal with them. Now we have moved to the next phase where TV stations are saying, okay, we are interested to take the signal. They are maybe not willing to pay the price we would like for it, but at this moment it's more important for us to actually gain visibility, and through the visibility increase the awareness of the sport and the market value of the sport. But for example, in this championship we have now both China, Singapore, Thailand are the non-European takers, and Canada. And then we have the traditional countries with Czech Republic, Finland, Sweden, Switzerland, Latvia, Denmark, Slovakia taking the signal, and a few others. We have N-crews from another country, so there is really good. And we, as I said, we have almost 150 TV games at the moment. We will see how, if we can get over that tomorrow.
The other big question, which is always interesting for the floorball community, what is the latest with Olympics? Is that still a topic?
The Olympics is a topic, but probably the event we are striving for now is the Youth Olympic Games in either 2022 or 2026, probably 2026. The Olympic Games for 24 in Paris and Los Angeles 28 seem to be quite closed. There will not be that many new sports on the program. And of course, the fact that floorball is not very big. It exists and it's well played in France and the US United States, but not big enough. And also there are other sports which have a much, much stronger traditional space. So it's the Youth Olympic Games, which is will be the front rower. And of course also if we can get the sport and in the sports lab and as initiation during the championships and the Olympic Games in 24 or 20. So 32 is probably the next time we have a real chance.
From an IFF perspective, what are the next biggest challenges?
Well, of course, it's the implementation, and as I said, to raise the awareness and the visibility and the market value, to start growing the federation, to get more bigger competitions, more teams involved, more countries involved, more players, and growing the whole thing, and also to be able to keep up the level of the competition which we have had here. We will have really good organizers in Finland in 2020 with the men's championship, but before that and after that we will have Switzerland and Sweden taking the world championships, first in 19 in Neuchâtel in the French-speaking part, where I believe that will be a new good thing for floorball in Switzerland and the French-speaking, maybe also France. And then we will have the women's championships in Uppsala in Sweden in 2021.
John, thank you very much for the insight and all the best.
Thank you very much.